So let me just, a couple of things come to mind with that. The first one is kind of a literary philosophical question. You know, how do you how do you determine a literary device from what is true? I mean, you know, how would they determine that? You know, and then
it's
secondly,
interesting question.
Yeah. And then secondly, the state of the nature of what's going on, I guess, in the you know, in the field. Where is it? Where is it headed? You know. Do you find a lot of pushback? Where's, you know, where are the scholars at these days?
Right, right. So how would they say that they can determine it from what is true? It's an excellent question. And it's especially an excellent question when you insist that this genre allowed for things to be changed. Dr. Lacona uses the phrase part and parcel, that these were part and parcel of the genre. If something is part and parcel of the genre, then quite frankly, we would expect them to be changed fairly widely. I mean, if I go in there and I say it's part and parcel of the genre of a biopic to change the facts, you're not going to expect there to just be one or two. You'd expect there to be quite a few. Right. In fact, you'd expect there to be ones that you never even guessed, that you never even suspected, right? Were right. changed because they're doing it in this very realistic way. So generally, their method that I find, one big method is what I call discrepancy hunting. And they'll do this with secular documents as well, that you go and you find an apparent discrepancy, and that's where you zero in and you say, aha, maybe this is where there's been a change. Now, that's not going to turn up all of them, you know. And the other thing is that they're very big on what they call multiple attestation. So if something is said in multiple gospels, like we were talking about earlier, does everything right. have to be said twice? Well, if you're a literary device theorist, it sure helps, you know, if something is said twice, because then you're like, okay, good. I'm going to take it that that's real, you know, but it might be at a fairly high level. So for example, that Jesus called himself the Son of Man. Is multiply attested because we find him calling himself the Son of Man in a lot of different gospels. But whether the specific incident where he called himself the Son of Man happened, that might be more of a question if it's only in one gospel, because then that specific thing is only singly attested. So we have to get, you know, we're going to end up defending things at a much higher level of generality. Is what I would say. And that's what they tend to do to try to distinguish fact from what I call fiction. They don't like the word fiction for some reason, but I mean, you know, honestly, fiction isn't necessarily an insult. I love fiction. My doctorate is in literature. Yeah. I love fiction. I'm not saying fiction is immoral, but I don't think the gospels are fiction. And frankly, I don't think the audience did think that way.
Right.
So I think the audience would have been misled. And now we have a problem. Now we do have a problem with honesty and dishonesty and so forth.